आई एम डॉक्टर जेसी जॉन, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एनाटमी, ज्योति विद्यापीठ, वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी, जयपुर. एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस एनाटमी ऑफ द एक्सटर्नल जेनिटलिया ऑफ द फीमेल. नमस्ते, हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया. एंड फर्स्ट वी विल टेक द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द फीमेल जेनिटलिया. एंड द जेनिटलिया, इट मीन्स रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गन्स इन द फीमेल, आर दोज कंसर्न्ड विद कोपुलेशन, fertilization, growth and development of the fetus, its subsequent exit into the outer world and nurture following birth. The generative organ constitute the external genitalia, the internal genital organ and the accessory reproductive organ. So these are the reproductive organ that is make a function of the fertilization, population, growth and development of the fetus and the subsequent exit into the outer world and nurture following birth. These are all come into the external genitalia. External genitalia, we will see the some structures, vulva and pudendum, includes all the visible external genitalia organ in the perineum. Vulva consists of the following structures. These are mons pubis, and we call also mons veneris, and labia majora and labia minora. These are the lips that present the outer side, and sometimes we will see the greater lips and lesser lips, and hymen, clitoris and vestibule, urethral opening and Skinny's gland, and the vaginal orifice or the introitus. We will see the orifice of the vagina, we will see it introitus, and there is the opening of Bartholin glands also. We can see the external genitalia here, and in more clearly in this colorful picture, how the labia majora and labia minora can see, and there is a clitoris, and there is the opening of the Bartholin glands, and you can see the vaginal orifice and the orifice of external urethra. Now we will see the mons veneris or the mons pubis. It is the pad of subcutaneous adipose connective tissue lying over the symphysis pubis, and it is covered by the pubic hair from the time of the puberty. Now we will see the labia majora. It is the outer side lip, and these are the two folds of the fat and areolar tissue and covered with skin and pubic hair on the outer surface. Inner surface of the labia majora are hairless, and labia majora are covered with squamous epithelium and contain sebaceous gland, sweat gland and hair follicles. This adipose tissue is richly supplied with venous plexus, which may produce hematoma if injured during childbirth. Labia majora arise from the mons veneris and merge into the perineum behind, and the round ligaments terminate at its upper borders. Beneath the skin, there is dense connective tissue and adipose tissue of the labia majora, and it is richly supplied by the venous plexus. And if any injury happened during the childbirth, there can be production, there can be echoes of the hematoma. And this is the homologous to the scrotum in the male, and round ligament terminates at its upper border. Now we'll see the labia minora. These are two thin folds of the skin lying between the labia majora, and anteriorly they divide to increase the clitoris, and posteriorly diffuse and forming the forget. It is usually lacerated during the childbirth, and between the forget and the vaginal orifice is the fossa navicularis. Labia minora do not contain hair follicles, but it fold contain connective tissue, numerous sebaceous gland, erectile muscle fibers and numerous vessels and nerve endings. Now we will see the clitoris. It is a small cylindrical erectile body measuring about 1.5 to 2.5 cm, situated in the most anterior part of the vulva, and it is a rudimentary organ corresponding to the male penis, but differs basically in being entirely separate from the urethra. It is attached to the undersurface of the symphysis pubis by the suspensory ligament, are extremely sensitive, highly vascular, and plays a role in the orgasm of the sexual intercourse. Now we will see the vestibular. It is a triangular space bounded anteriorly by the clitoris, posteriorly by the fourchette, and other side by labia minora. And there are four openings into the vestibule. These are the urethral opening and the opening of the skinny glands and vaginal orifice and the opening of the Bartholin glands. We will see the urethral opening. This opening is situated in the midline, just in front of the vaginal orifice, about 2.5 cm posterior to the clitoris. And the skinny glands opens on either side of the urethral orifice and vaginal orifice or the introitus. Vaginal orifice, it occupies the posterior 2/3 of the vestibule and of varying size and shape. In virgins and newly peri, the opening is closed by the labia minora, but in perious women, it may be exposed. It is completely closed by a septum of mucous membrane. That membrane is called hymen, and the membrane varies in shape, but is usually circular or precentric in virgins. Hymen is usually ruptured at the conception of the marriage. Now we'll see the opening of Bartholin glands. There are two Bartholin glands, one on each side. They open on either side of the vaginal orifice and lie in the posterior part of the labia majora. They are open on either side of the vaginal orifice and lie in posterior part of the labia majora. They are P-shaped and yellowish white in color, and during the sexual excitement, it secretes abundant alkaline mucus, which helps in lubrication. Each gland has a duct, which measures about 2 cm and open into the vestibule outside the hymen, and this duct is lined by the columnar epithelium. Now we will see the blood supply of the external genitalia, and this comes from the internal and external pudendal arteries, and blood drains through the corresponding veins. Lymphatic drain into the inguinal lymph nodes and internal iliac lymph nodes, and the supplied supply will be the from the branches of the pudendal nerve. Anterior part is supplied by the genitofemoral nerve and posterior inferior part by the pudendal branches from the posterior cutaneous nerve of the thigh. The vulva is supplied by the labial and perineal branches of the pudendal nerve. Now there are some assessment questions. These are, first is, explain anatomy of the clitoris, and you have to explain about it. And second is, what is the Bartholin glands and what is the function of it? Explain about it. Thank you so much.